Good evening. I'm Micah Mater.
And I'm Joe Donlin. Thank you for joining us. New here at 9, a wheel from a helicopter came crashing down on a home in suburban Linwood. Luckily, no one was hurt, but it did cause a lot of damage.
WGN's Eric Rung is live at the Lansing Municipal Airport tonight with our story. Eric.
Good evening. Apparently, that wheel was never supposed to be on the helicopter, but an inexperienced crew forgot to remove it, so gravity did it for them.
Saturday night, sometime between 2 and 7, Linda Taylor Witt's a longtime belief that something connected to the nearby Lansing Municipal Airport would hit her house.
Always felt like something was going to fall off of a plane or a helicopter was going to scrape the top of the house or something.
Turns out it was a wheel from a helicopter that came crashing down while Taylor Witt and her family were celebrating a birthday at a nearby Applebee's. When they got back to the house, her daughter went to use a hallway washroom when she heard what she thought were footsteps. She soon found out it was actually the rain pouring through the hole in the roof that the wheel made. She started screaming.
When I got up to the top of the stairs, they was, get in here, hurry up, hurry up. And they were pointing at the ceiling. And the tire was coming through the ceiling. The water was coming down. Plaster was all over the tub.
Not knowing who to call, she decided to call the police.
How do you even make that phone call? Like, what do you say without them thinking that it's a prank phone call?
I was so nervous. I was like, I don't know what's happened or how it got here, but there's a tire coming through my ceiling in my washroom, and I don't know who to call.
Soon, police and firefighters were on her roof to push the wheel through the hole. A contractor friend plugged the hole. She says the owners of the wheel and the helicopter it belonged to, Summer Skies Flight School, gave her a call today.
They were taking responsibility for it, and whatever needed to be done, they would take care of it.
When I talked to the owner tonight, she stopped herself halfway through confirming what she told the Tribune, that an inexperienced pilot didn't remove the wheels before taking off because it was usually done by a ground crew. She said it was under investigation. Taylor Witt doesn't need an investigation to know her bathroom needs a lot of work, and she just missed one heck of a scare.
If I had been here, I probably would have had a heart attack. I mean, can you imagine something, a big old metal, you saw the pictures of the tire. That had to be an awful loud bang.
It is awfully hard to believe, and yes, that would be an awfully loud bang. Now, apparently, there was also a second tire that fell from the helicopter. That fell in Linda's neighbor's yard. That luckily didn't do any damage. We're live in Linwood. I'm Eric Rung, WGN News.
Wow. Thanks, Eric.